was a great environment. It did have an NCAA tournament atmosphere. You know, those out games, there's nothing like them. Thought Tennessee had a great NIT crowd. I'm sure proud of the Blue Raiders who came up from Murfreesboro. Just proud of our team. I mean, I thought we just absorbed a ton of foul trouble in the first half, hung on. And then I thought in the second half, Tennessee made a great run. And really, Bruce Massey, you know, he really took the game over defensively, driving the ball, made late game free throws. And then, you know, to end it against a team like that in a 15-0 run, that's difficult to do here in this arena.
Question for players.
Bruce, you're not a scorer. Can you talk about kind of how your mentality changed over the last few minutes?
Hitting free throws early to start the game. I hit 4 free throws. I could see the basket getting a little bigger. And my teammates told me stay in attack mode. Stay in attack mode all game long. Just be smart about it and pick your spots when to attack.
Did you feel like there that last layup that you made, the bank shot, did you feel like you guys were going to win it at that point? Was there a sense that was the game-winning basket, anything like that?
It was a sense. We went up 3. We knew we were guarding 3-point line well all game. It wasn't fortunately hitting any 3, so we knew we had a slight advantage going on 3. We wasn't sure the game was over yet. We knew we had to get one more stop.
Ron, you said you wanted to have a special leave a mark in your one season. Do you feel like this is the first win over UT, I think, 24 years or so? Is that the mark that you were wanting?
Yeah, man, I want to keep on going. I feel like this is a special team. You know, we got down a little bit, but, you know, as a team, like a family, you know, Coach Davis, he picked us up. You know, the team, ourselves on the court, he picked ourselves up. And, you know, we came out 15-0 run, and we won the game. When you got a coach that's into the game and want to win, you know, it picks you up. You know, when you get a technical, he going hard for us. So they told us, like, hey, we got to pick it up, man, and this is what we did.
LaRon, it looked like you guys had the lead for so long, and then they jumped in and get up 8. It felt like that they were going to run away with it there. How did that really turn in the last 7-8 minutes?
You talking the first half?
At the second half. When they're up, it looks like they're going to go.
We knew that we had to know do what we do best, and like executing offense and then lock hard on defense. They was getting a lot of offensive rebounds, second chances. So you know we knew that we stopped them from getting second chances, and then we executed, you know, through offense, and we're gonna win the game. That's what happened.
For both of you guys, I know you're not from Tennessee, but still, can you appreciate what this means to Middles and coming to Knoxville, Big Tennessee?
Definitely. Growing up, you know, you watch Tennessee basketball on TV all the time. You know the history at this school. So to come in, even though I'm not from Tennessee, but to play with Middle Tennessee, to know that Tennessee has a greater edge in the win column versus Middle Tennessee, to get this win tonight, you definitely can appreciate it, even though you're not from Tennessee.
Like Bruce said, man, growing up watching Tennessee, man, and, you know, actually playing and getting a victory over Tennessee, that's big time, man. You know, we're going to take this and cherish this and keep going.
Bruce, it just seemed like late in the game, both teams were really exhausted, tired. How did you guys just find that extra energy there to pull this one out?
We were in the same situation versus Vandy early in the season, and we was fighting hard, but we got tired down the stretch, and they got tired, but they made an extra push, which gave them the victory. So tonight, we didn't want to quit. We knew we were going to lose. We were going to give it all. We wasn't going to quit. We found the extra energy to keep going. Coach Davis told us, don't stop. No quitting tonight. If we're going to lose, giving it your all. No stopping.
LaRon, let's talk about how you guys just kind of weathered the foul troubles and everything. How tough was it the second half, knowing every post seemed to be have 2 or 3 fouls?
It was very tough, but, you know, we knew that we had to go out and play. We still had to play, you know, not worry about the foul troubles. I knew that it was a good chance for me to get my fifth foul out, but I knew I had to, you know, do it playing hard.
LaRon, you guys have had some big wins this year, but what were you getting from the fan base and the students and on campus about how important this game was for them?
Oh, man, my Twitter was blowing up before the game, the day before the game. Like, man, y'all got to beat UT, you know, beat them, man. It means a lot to us, and it means much more to y'all. So, you know, there was a big time.
Are you surprised that y'all rebounded Tennessee about 6-8?
Oh, wow. Nah, like really, you know, Coach Davis, you know, in practice, you know, we got a physical practice, and that's all we're doing is rebounding. He came on to stressing us, like, no, you know, you got to rebound, out rebound. And we knew that, he had 17 and 20 rebounds, you know, per game, almost per game, stuff like that. So we knew we had to come in and out rebound and stop them from getting extra rebounds.
Anything else?
That's for the players.
Job, man.
Thanks, Coach.
Job, guys.
Thank y'all.
And middle, by the way, will be in dressing room for one.
Okay. Thanks, Bruce.
Kermit, can you just talk about the 15-0 run and how that kind of turned?
You know, we got in the timeout. I think it's like, I can't remember exactly, Adam. You'd probably tell me exactly how much time was left. But, you know, we just talked about just we got to win it on the defensive end. There's plenty, tons of possessions left. And I thought we started redding and trapping the post. It was good. They probably missed a couple shots that were open because they got tired. And then I thought Bruce just attacked. And we made late game free throws. I mean, he made late game free throws. So we took advantage of every possession.
Your guys have had some disappointments on not getting to the NCAA and getting to the tournament and all that. What does that say for them that this has kind of turned around?
Well, I think it speaks for the character of the players and then the job that you know, how they responded. And it started with LaRon Dindy. You know, we were devastated after Hot Springs, and we still had our hopes that maybe we could get an at-large bid. But we kind of prepared them for the NIT and talked about what a great tournament it was. And it started with LaRon, and we took that Monday off, drove back, and we got right back in the gym on Tuesday, and we followed his lead. And he led our team, and he's had great energy. And then those other guys were just terrific. So we've had some really, really good practices over the last 2 weeks. Oh, it does. I mean, it means a lot to me. I mean, it means a lot to our staff, and I know it means a lot to our fan base. So we understand how good Tennessee has been and how good this team this year has been in this building, in the SEC. So it was difficult, but I really mean this, and I told our guys, maybe we'll cherish this because it was Tennessee in a month, but it's a quick turnaround. And I mean, when we get on that bus, it's got to get behind us, and we'll find out tonight going home whether we'll play Minnesota at home or at Miami. With 27 wins and the most wins in the school history and all the firsts that this team has done, I think it adds on to it, you know, and when you beat an in-state rival like Tennessee. And what I love about our team, we've been in two outstanding games on the road against two really good teams, Vanderbilt and Tennessee. So it I'm sure it ranks up there high. But like I said, we got to put it behind us real quick.
Is it your biggest win?
Here? I would say so. Probably would be, just because of it was an out game, an advance in a national tournament. So obviously, I think that it would be.
Just talk about how you guys weathered the storm here. I mean, obviously, you were in horrible foul trouble. I don't think you fouled anyone out. I mean, just talk about how you guys weathered that, and when you guys had to, you came up with the big 15-0 run.
Yeah, you know who I really thought gave us a great lift was the hometown product, James Gallman. I mean, we were having a hard time to score. We were playing Jacques Rozier, a freshman who hadn't played in a while. Torrin Walker was about to fall out because he hadn't played about a minute and a half or 2 minutes at one time. And we kept getting – so we and James made two big threes to kind of weather it. And we could have said if we could just get into that halftime even two – and I thought he was a big part of the end of that first half.
Anybody else? Don't you talk about Bruce's play at the end of the game? He had a steal and that block shot.
Well, you know, he 10 rebounds, too. I tell you, he's been unbelievable. There's a stat in college basketball that's really interesting. I think he's the only point guard in college basketball that has more blocks and steals than turnovers. And it's a great stat to keep on point guards. And it shows toughness and gaining possessions. And that's what he did at the end. He just got us possessions. And then what he did that he hadn't done a lot was really attack the rim on a consistent basis. Excuse me? Well, we're going to set some high ball screens because we thought that, you know, we wanted Stokes, as good as he is, you know, like a lot of young guys, even my guys, they're not great at defending the high ball screen. But I don't really think we just thought we were just going to go to Bruce and go to Bruce. But the game just unfolded that way, and he just felt like he was going to have a chance to score and attack the rim. All right, thanks, guys. Thank you.